Hey, Savior from the Redneck Garage. I was working on cleaning out the garage. There's a big surprise, right? And I came across something that I bought a while ago called the kilowatt. And I thought it'd be interesting if we talked today a little bit about electricity. You remember when you were a kid, your parents would say stupid stuff to you like, every time you turn on and off that light switch, it costs a nickel. Today we're going to debunk that and say, why, that isn't really true. When I was cleaning out the garage, I found my kilowatt, which is a meter, and it's got a lot of cool features on it that we're going to go over. But basically, what it's going to do is going to tell us how much power something uses, and then from that we can kind of gauge on how much it costs. That's helpful, because this week I kept telling my kids to turn off the lights in their rooms when they went to school, and I thought to myself, I wonder how much it really costs when they leave a light on all day while they're in school and I come home and the lights are still on. So we're going to answer that question of how much is coming out of your pocket every week when your kids can't turn a stinking light bulb off.
This is your electric meter. It is not your friend. Look at that thing spinning. What's going on with that? Okay, so let's take a look how the kilowatt works. It has a lot of different measurements. Right now it's measuring 122.4 volts. It will also tell you your amps. There's no amp draw on this right now because there's nothing plugged into it. Watts should be zero. Zero on the voltage. Hertz, 59 hertz. Whatever that one is, I don't know. And there's your kilowatts per hour and a timer. Okay, so I'm going to plug in the fluorescent light and we're going to take a look. Okay, so now I'm looking at the fluorescent light. And one thing about lighting is it is a constant draw. It's not like it goes up or goes down. So I don't have to be concerned about measuring the kilowatts per hour because basically that's for something that has different variables and you're doing it over time because you can't figure out how much it's using. All I really need to know is the wattage. Okay? And then I'm going to show you how to figure that out in just a minute. But, for instance, 28 watts is what this fluorescent bulb set is using. Okay, 28 watts, constant 28 watts. So that's cool. That's all I need to remember at this moment. Now let's say I wanted to look at my new LED shop light, which is super cool, super bright, and I measure it, it's plugged in, it's taking up 56 watts. Huh. So it actually uses more power than the fluorescent, which I did not know. I thought it would have been more energy efficient, but because of, I guess, the number of LEDs, it uses more than the fluorescent bulbs themselves. I'm going to take my fluorescent bulb, which is one of the bigger ones, and I'm going to plug it in and see what it actually does. So we're going to plug this in. Okay, so what is our wattage? 23 watts. Very cool. So we know that the fluorescent, the bigger one, runs 23 watts. And we've got one more test to do before we move on to the ciphering part. This is the old standby. This is what we grew up with. This is what everybody used up until the advent of the fluorescent bulbs that are probably mercury laden and kill you if they break and all that stuff. But this is a 60 watt bulb. What? What did you say? A 60 watt bulb? Oh, maybe there's a clue in there. We're going to go ahead and plug this in to our light. And there it is. And how many watts do you think a 60 watt bulb would pull? 61 watts! So there you go. That's kind of the clue on that bulb.
Okay, so now we've got our numbers off of our electric appliances. The next thing you got to figure out is what you're being charged for electricity. When I went to Middle Tennessee Electric Membership Corporation to look up the kilowatts per hour usage fee, what you're paying every month, right? It said that we have some of the lowest rates in the country, and it's, you know, from TVA, and, you know, some of our power is buying down hydroelectric. There's a couple nuclear plants. But anyway, I was surprised to find out that my electric rate was 8.467 per kilowatt hour, right? Then the more interesting thing is when I started looking up different areas of the country, there's a huge variance of electrical pricing in the United States of America, truthfully. Where do you think the highest would be? That's right, California, where all those green freaks are, right? We got to save money. We can't have a power plant. Don't make any nuclear. Yeah, well, they're paying for it. All, you know, all the growth that they've had in California, and they don't build power plants, jacks up the price of their energy. That's right. It just tears them up. Let's just say 8.5 for all intents and purposes right here in Franklin, Tennessee. I'm paying 8.5 cents per kilowatt hour. If you move to Los Angeles, your average is going to be 22.3 cents a kilowatt hour. In the United States, where do you think the highest cost for electricity would be? Hawaii. Why is the highest? It's 37.3 on average. Can you imagine what your electric bill would be in Hawaii? Holy crap. You do not want to do anything out there. Average across the United States is 11.88 cents per kilowatt hour. So there you go. I've got my number, which is the 8.5 roughly, and I'm going to do some figuring on this. If my child left his light on for 5 hours, how much would that cost me on the different lights? Okay, so we'll go through that in just a second. So I've just gone to the internet, and this is rapidtables.com. You can go anywhere you want, though, basically. And it's a watts to kilowatt hour calculator, okay, which is super cool. Okay, so we're going to put the power in the watts, and we'll just say the fluorescent light first. And that's 28 watts is what it was pulling, right? And let's just use, as an example, 1 hour, because that'll give us a base. And then our number is going to be, right, this is math, 028. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and figure up the rest of them off of my wattage figures, and then I'll be back. Okay, so I'm all done with my figures, and I've got my results. Just one quick note on the kilowatt. The way that we used it today was just looking at the watts of how many watts it makes. But if you really wanted to get an idea of, let's say you want to know how much power your kid's using with his TV and his Xbox and everything else, you could put a power strip in here and hit it onto, kilowatts per hour, and then give it a measured like a week. And it would pretty much tell you how much you burned during that week, because that's a variable, right? It's using some more at one time and less at the other. But the longer you use it on there, the more it will average it out. And you could use that with anything, right? But with lighting, constant. Okay, so here's the figures on the lighting.
An incandescent bulb, if you ran it for 5 hours a day for 30 days, would run you 78 cents. If it was an LED or a compact fluorescent, really, would be 30 cents a day. The fluorescent bar out in the garage would be 36 cents, and the LED light bar would be 59 cents. Wow. Okay, so then the other thing that's really amazing is if you were to compare Franklin, Tennessee, where I live, and let's say Los Angeles, where all the freak, liberal, can't have a gun, have to be green people live, I would be paying 30 cents at the end of that month, and they would be paying 79 cents. So you can imagine what their electric bills would be after a month compared to mine. What that would tell me is the South rules.
So if your kid leaves the light on his room once, then, you know, it's not that bad. But what that does tell you is that you need to be looking at all your lights and try to turn them out as much as possible, and that'll reduce energy savings. But the true energy savings is this, boys and girls. Your number one user of electricity in your home is what? Your HVAC unit. If you can turn your thermostat up during the summer and down during the winter, you'll save money. The second largest user of electricity in your home is what? Any guesses? It would be your water heater. So if you've got three teenagers and they're in the shower taking 2 hour showers until all the hot water's gone, you're paying out the butt for hot water. So you need to start shutting that down. That'll save you a lot of money. And then the third cost of electricity, the third largest, is going to be refrigeration, refrigerators, freezers, things like that. And then everything else kind of falls in between. If you get you one of these kilowatts, you can kind of go back through and you can see, you can kind of experiment on seeing what is the biggest energy users in your home. Mine's teenagers, I'm pretty sure. Hope you enjoyed it today. You know what? We just hit 1,200 subscribers, and I want to just take a second to say thank you for being a subscriber of the Redneck Garage. Appreciate it. It's been fun so far. We'll just keep on keeping on. Keep turning wrenches.